What is the VLC media player? VLC is a simple, powerful, and fast media player. VLC supports Windows, Linux, Unix, iOS, and Mac. It's available for free as open source software under the new public license. It plays almost every multimedia file format on the planet. If you've ever tried to play various media files with Windows Media Player, or others, you would find that you constantly needed to download codec packs to support the latest video. A codec is a device or software that enables compression and decompression of digital multimedia files. Codecs allow video files to be much smaller than they would be without the use of a codec. The downside is that the codec must be installed in the media player to be able to decompress and view the file. VLC Media Player supports all the codecs you'll ever need. It plays everything, from files, disks, webcams, and streams. Let's download and install the VLC Media Player. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. In the address bar, enter videolan.org. That's videolan.org. The VideoLAN homepage will open. Currently it's showing the release of VLC 2.0. This won't be here forever, so I'll go through the normal method to download the software. Click on the VLC menu, and then click on the Download VLC button. You'll be redirected to the SourceForge site for the download. On the Download information bar, click the Run button. This will download the file and then automatically start the installer. On the Installer Language window, click the OK button. On the Welcome screen, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, read the License Agreement, and then click the Next button. On the Choose Component screen, leave the default and then click Next. On the Choose Install Location screen, click the Install button. On the Completing screen, deselect Run VLC Media Player, and then click the Finish button. We deselected the running of VLC after setup, so that it could demonstrate the two ways you can open VLC Media Player. Option 1, you can double-click on the VLC Media Player icon on the desktop. Option 2, you can click the Windows Start button, All Programs, Video LAN, and then select VLC Media Player. Now most times you're not going to open VLC Media Player and then go open the file. You're probably going to have a Windows Explorer window open, and then you'll just go and double-click on the file to open and run it. Now I have a sample video to work with here. This is just a video I took of some blue jays that were playing around in the backyard at the bird feeder. Now if we double-click on this file, it's going to open in the VLC Media Player. Now it's opening in VLC Player because we left the option selected during setup to associate VLC with the audio and video files. Now over time this may change, or for some reason the files might not be opening correctly in VLC and instead be opening in Windows Media Player or something else. If for some reason the association changes and the video is opening in another program like Windows Media Player, you can easily change this. All you need to do is right-click on the file, and then move down to where it says Open With. Here we can see that this computer has the option to open the file with the DivX player, VLC Media Player, or with Windows Media Player. If the video is opening in Media Player, and we selected VLC from this list here, it would open this type of file in VLC only this one time. After we closed it out, and then the next time we try to open the file by double-clicking on it, it would open in Media Player again. To permanently change the default program to open the file, we need to select Choose Default Program from the list. The Open With window will open. Under Recommended Downloads, it'll show a listing of three programs we had in the right-click menu. There are also additional options if you click the down arrow next to other programs. At the bottom of this window, there's an option labeled Always Use the Selected Program to Open This Kind of File. We need to ensure that this is selected. This is the option that makes sure that the selection we make here is permanent. We'll select VLC Media Player from the list, and then click the OK button. And the video will then go ahead and open up in VLC. Now, at its core, VLC Media Player is an incredibly easy program to use for basic viewing of videos and listening to audio. This tutorial is just going to cover basic viewing of the files, but keep in mind that there's a ton of advanced features to view in the future. You can watch DVD and Blu-ray discs and ignore the DVD region coding. You can stream audio and video like radio and television stations. And you can connect to DV capture cards in your computer to record and watch TV shows. You can even use VLC to create screencasts and record the desktop like I've done in this program. Let's review the basic interface and controls. At the bottom of the screen, you have the play, pause, and stop controls. You can also use the spacebar to play and pause the file. At the bottom right of the screen, you can adjust the volume controls. This is separate from the volume controls that are down here in the system tray. Just below where the video is, there's a timeline that shows the full length of the video and gives you a slider to move through the video. To make the video full screen, double-click anywhere in the video. Now, when you're in full screen and you're moving the mouse around, the control will show up at the bottom of the screen. Once you stop moving the mouse, the controls will disappear. You should now have VLC Media Player downloaded and installed, as well as understand how to use VLC to view multimedia files.